parque, en la plaza, en el cine yo te busqué. Te tengo atrapada entre mi piel y mi alma, mas ya no puedo.
Hey, welcome back! Learn Spanish with lyrics. Rayando el Sol by Maná, featuring Pablo Alborán. Rayando el Sol means sun is rising, dawn is breaking, morning has come. Rayando is present participle of the verb rayar, meaning to scratch or to line, to border or to scribble. El is a definite article meaning the, and the sol is a masculine noun meaning sun, so el sol is the sun. Rayar el sol means to break dawn, so basically it's representing the morning. And there is a more commonly used phrase which is rayar el alba, and alba means dawn. Rayando being present participle, Rayando el sol, a translation would be breaking the dawn. And to put it in the better perspective, the rayo is actually masculine noun, means rays and beam. So you could imagine the picture of rayando el sol. The very first ray of light coming out of the horizon when the morning comes. Rayando por ti, rising for you. The sun is rising for you. Por is a preposition. It could mean for, by, through, or because of, depending on the context. Ti is a pronoun referring to you. So por ti means for you. It's a phrase. Esta is a feminine version of adjective, meaning this. Pena is a feminine noun, meaning sorrow, pity, trouble, or problem. Esta pena, this pain hurts me. Duele is the third person singular present of the verb doler, meaning to hurt. Me quema sin tu amor. Sin is a preposition meaning without. Amor is a masculine noun meaning love. So tu amor is your love, as tu is an adjective referring to your. Quema is a third person singular of the verb quemar, meaning to burn, scorch, or set on fire. Me quema sin tu amor. It burns me without your love. No me has llamado. Has llamado is the second person singular present perfect of the verb llamar, meaning to call. You haven't called me. Estoy desesperado. Estoy is the first person singular present of the verb estar, meaning to be. And desesperado is a past participle of the verb desesperar, to drive crazy, and also adjective meaning desperate. I am desperate. Son muchas lunas. Muchas is the feminine version of adjective meaning many in the plural form. Lunas is the feminine noun moon and its plural form, so it means moons. Son is the third person plural present for the verb ser, meaning to be. There are many moons, referring to the cycles of the moons. Las que te he llorado. He llorado is the first person singular present perfect of the verb llorar, meaning to cry. Las is pronoun meaning them. Here it refers to the moons. Que is a conjunction meaning that. So the literal translation will be, there are so many moons that I have cried for you. Desesperación is a feminine noun meaning desperation or exasperation. Es más fácil llegar al sol. It is easier to get to the sun. Es is the third person singular present for the verb ser, to be. Llegar is an infinitive form meaning to reach, get, arrive, come, and become. So with the preposition a behind it, it means get to. Al is a combined form of preposition a and a definite article el. So a el sol becomes al sol. Más is adverb meaning more or the most, depending on the context. Fácil is adjective meaning easy or likely. Es más fácil llegar al sol que tu corazón. Más que is a phrase meaning more than. So más bra bra que bra bra means more bra bra than bra bra. Tu is an adverb meaning your. Corazón is a masculine noun meaning the heart. Me muero por ti. Me muero is a reflexive verb, the first person singular for the verb morirse. It means to die or to be dying of. Viviendo sin ti. Sin is a preposition meaning without. Sin ti is without you, as T is pronoun referring to you. Viviendo is a present participle for the verb vivir, meaning to live. Living without you. Y no aguanto. Y is a conjunction meaning and. No is an adverb meaning not, as a negation. Aguanto is a first person singular present of the verb aguantar, meaning to bear. I cannot bear this. Me duele tanto estar así. Duele is a third person singular present for the verb doler, meaning to hurt. Me is a pronoun meaning me as a direct object to the verb, in this case, doler. Tanto is an adverb meaning so much. Estar is the infinitive form of the verb estar, meaning to be. And así is an adverb meaning like this or like that. A tu casa yo fui. Fui is the first person singular pretérito of the verb ir, meaning to go. Casa is a feminine noun, meaning house or home. and a is a preposition meaning to. Y no te encontré, and I didn't see you. Encontré is the first person singular predicate of the verb encontrar, meaning to find. Te is a pronoun meaning you as an indirect object. And te encontré means I found you. En el parque, meaning in the park. En is a preposition meaning in, and parque is a masculine noun meaning park. En la plaza, meaning in the plaza. La is a feminine definite article, da, and plaza is a feminine noun, square or marketplace. En el cine, yo te busqué. Busqué is the first person singular predicate of the verb buscar, meaning to look for. Again, te is a pronoun meaning you as an indirect object, and cine is a masculine noun meaning movie theater. Te tengo atrapada. Atrapada is a feminine version of the adjective meaning trapped, or first participle of the verb atrapar, meaning to catch or to trap. Tengo is the first person singular present of the verb tener, meaning to have. So, te tengo atrapada means I have you trapped between my skin and my soul. Entre mi piel y mi alma. Entre is a preposition meaning between, and mi is an adjective meaning my blah blah. Piel is a feminine noun meaning skin, and alma is a feminine noun meaning soul. Between my skin and my soul. Más ya no puedo tanto. Puedo is the first person singular present of the verb poder, meaning to be able or can. Ya is an adverb meaning already or now. Y quiero estar junto a ti. I want to be with you. Quiero is first person singular present of the verb querer, meaning to want or to love. Junto is an adjective meaning together. A phrase junto a ti meaning with you.
Rayando el sol, rayando por ti. Esta pena me duele, me quema sin tu amor. No me has llamado, estoy desesperado. Son muchas lunas las que te he llorado. Rayando el sol, I fui es fácil llegar al sol que a tu corazón.
One of the good reasons that I think learning a language by music, lyrics, is that it's not only the language itself, but it's also the culture. It's about the song and the feeling of the person in the culture. It's the story of the people in that culture and the language. Thank you for watching.